הוא הופיע בישראל כבר עשרות פעמים, והספיק למלא את קיסריה, גם לא מעט, הסטאר החסידי הבינלאומי, שאין כמעט חופה יהודית בעולם, שהלעיתים שלו, אם ישכחך ירושלים, או בוי בשלום, לא מתנגדים בה. ועכשיו הוא כאן איתנו עם אלבום חדש, עשירי במספר, שלום ליעקב שווקי.
שלום וברכה, hi, how are you? It's great to be here.
So, tell me a little bit, how do you feel here in Israel again?
It's always a unique and great feeling to be here in Israel. פה בארץ הקודש, כמו שאומרים. And it's a feeling you can't get anywhere in the world. I travel all over and I tell people ask me, what's your favorite place in the world? And with ease, I say Israel, because this is where your heart is. This is where, you know, every Jew's heart is. Libi b'mizrach, kamo she'amarnu.
In your performances and also in your song, you always dedicated a very warm spot to the Israeli soldier, to IDF.
That's right.
You did quite of work in this field. So you can tell me a little bit about it? Well, why it's so special to you?
It's special because, especially a guy like me, that's from America, a religious guy, you know, and it's very important for me to get the message out. I do it for my own children. When we come here, I always tell them, go over to a soldier and say thank you. Even though you live in America, you live all over the world, remember, there are people that are sacrificing their lives, you know, for you. So it's important, also a lesson to my kids. And also in general, the gift of music has given me so much. It's important to use that language, especially coming from a guy that lives, you know, all over, you know, in America and this and that. They think that we're so far, yet we're very, very close. I want to give that message of love, which I do appreciate very, very much all the time. And I wanted to do it. We did a big concert in Nokia, you know, years ago, only dedicated to soldiers. I took the words of Mishe Berach L'Chayalim, made a song out of it just to show them as much as I can the love and the appreciation for what they do.
I really need to ask you, you actually, your music, it's Hasidic music in general.
I don't call it Hasidic music.
Yeah, but it's Jewish. It's more Jewish.
Music.
Yeah.
Correct.
But do you think that to your songs should connect it also, you know, secular, also even non-Jewish
no
people?
Listen, they call it Hasidi over here in Israel. I don't know why that name struck, but it is what it is. But it's inspirational messages for anybody.
Mm-hmm.
Your Time can be, by the way, the song Your Time could be a regular American song.
Mm-hmm.
It's songs like, you know, I have a song, Ishtabach Shemo La'ad, on this. Everybody says that in Israel. You know, it's songs, many, many of these songs, Musica is the mm-hmm. name of the album. It's about music, how mm-hmm. music, you know, revives us and helps us and gets us, you know, to dance and gets, it's messages for all, you know, to put a label on it, mm-hmm. Hasidi is not really the title that it should be.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why I call this album Musica, because music mm-hmm. in general is a language
people.
Of love.
Okay. Do you
sure.
see secular people even in Israel, in your shows?
Many.
Many.
Many, many. It's always like that. And I get emails and letters, and I meet a lot of them. And they tell me that this music also gets them to, it's an uplift. It's not just, you know, songs without any tochen. There mm-hmm. are songs that are, you know, have a depth to it. And then there are mm-hmm. songs called etrekod, where it's a time to dance. You know,
yeah.
there is...
Right.
So they feel a lot of not religious come. I appreciate it very much because I want this music to reach, you know, many different people. It's not only the fact that I'm religious doesn't mm-hmm. mean that the music is not universal. You know,
okay.
that's the key.
Even in your song that you mentioned earlier, the new one from the album,
mm-hmm. Your
you
Time,
always, right? Yeah, right. You always approach to youth. You always think about the young generation, even kids with special needs. You always have, you know, a warm spot also to children.
First of all,
the
I do
young
also,
generation.
I do. My wife also has an organization for special mm-hmm. children. It's over 400 families for many, many years. It's almost 20 years. It's an $8 million a year organization. It's something very, very big that she gives her life to. So we're very, very, you know, tight with always the kids, special kids, of course. And I try to travel all over the world, in the U.S. especially, and sing in different schools that have different types of kids, you know, not only religious kids. And it's something very important to me. It makes me cry sometimes walking away and saying, this is all worth it. You know, to be a singer and to go around is great, and I love it. Don't get me wrong, every single thing is important. But this especially puts a place in my heart and says, you know what? It's all worth it to see these kids that a lot of them didn't grow up, you know, with a religious background, which is fine. It's the way they are. And they're great kids. They have so much to them. But yet they're singing songs of uplift. They get inspired. It really gets me emotional that way, no question.
So what you're going to do here today, it's there, from your new album,
from the
right?
New album, Musica, we're going to do a song that was inspired, actually a song in English. First of all, your English is pretty good. So I'm sure you'll understand.
Enjoy it.
There's many, many songs that we could pick from this great new album. It's a song that was inspired by my own child who came home from school and told me, you know, Daddy, I try so hard in class, but the person next to me who doesn't try at all gets such great marks and is so, you know, the tests come in 195, gets very good mifchanim. And I try so hard and I don't get, you know, I barely pass the test. So I told him, my son, I told him, who do you think Hashem appreciates more? The person who struggles and gets a low mark, or the person who goes with ease and gets, you know, high marks? We have to understand that in our world, we look at results. You know, everything is results. In his world and in the real world, they look at the struggle and how hard you tried. I told him, if you try your best, I'm proud of you no matter what. And it inspired me to write a song for many kids, you know, children, the future, to realize that growing up in school, not easy for some of these kids, but to realize that if you try your best, you can be anything you want to be, and it's your time. So we did a song, you know, called Your Time, where it's in English. We'll do that here soon. And it was a great inspiration, you know, to all the youth to understand that you try your best and everything, you know, you leave everything up to him.
Yaakov Shveki, thank you very, very much, and welcome
greatest
to Israel.
Pleasure. My greatest pleasure.
Again.
Thank you. It's great to be here in Israel. I thank all the people who are reading this and listening. It's a privilege and a zechut to come to Israel to sing. And Musica, listen, what an album. Thank you.
Thank you very much.